Greetings one, greetings all. This is a video response to Flieger. His latest video about Christmas. And he brought up the subject about gifts and what typically happens in your household around Christmas time. And by the way, I'm drinking a beer brewed locally here. Leinenkugel. Fireside Nut Brown. Good stuff. Smoking the beat up Hackert. From Star of the East. Hey, we got some underlying Christmas themes going on here. We got Fireside Nut Brown Beer, Star of the East. Tobacco. Well, anyway, I just kind of wanted to shed some insight a little bit on our situation. When I was a little boy, as kids, you always had requests for things. You saw things, and you're like, oh, I gotta have that, I'd like that for Christmas, whatever. Sometimes I would get those requests, sometimes I didn't. We were not a family of means when I was growing up, so Christmas was pretty sparse as far as fancy gifts, and unlike today where kids are asking for $300-$400 gifts and stuff like that. Back in my day, but I would get some nice stuff. But I think the thing that my parents always kept in mind that was that Christmas is about surprises. It's about traditions. It's about remembrance for the reason of the holiday, and it's about surprises. So they would, my mother now, my dad not so much, but my mother knew what my interests were as a child, and if she approved of them, see, that was the big thing, if she approved of them, she would, in her shopping ventures all year long, would run across things in a store or something and would think to herself, ooh, Kenny would like that. I'll get that for him for Christmas. It could be the middle of June. So she was thinking about Christmas gifts all throughout the year, purchasing things, stashing them away, to give them out on Christmas morning. And that's what Christmas, part of what Christmas should be about. You should be thinking about giving gifts for those special people in your family all year long, not just 2 weeks prior to Christmas. And that's what's happening in my life right now. I'm married, have been for many years. My wife doesn't really like surprises because there's a good chance you can get surprises wrong. And a wrong surprise means a headache for her, because then she has to take the surprise back to the store and try to get the money back and ultimately get what she wanted in the first place. So what happens in our household is approximately 2 weeks before Christmas, or maybe a little earlier, the questions start to fly. Well, hon, what do you want for Christmas? What? What's on your Christmas list? Huh? Granted, I've been wanting things all throughout the year, but I just never grab a piece of paper or have a notebook set aside that's Kenny's wish list, you know, and scribble it down in there so that when she asks that question 48 hours prior to Christmas, I can whip out the notebook and say, I'd like A, B, C, and D. But the thing that I miss is the surprise factor. Christmas morning, tradition in our house when I was growing up, and a tradition to this day, was each person would hide their presents for the rest of the family that they were giving. They'd stash them somewhere in their room or somewhere in the house where only they knew where they were. Or maybe the help of a parent. If it was something for my sister, my dad would let me hide them up in the attic or something like that. And on Christmas morning, after we sat down and read the Bible and read the Christmas story and had Christmas breakfast and we were sitting around the tree waiting to open presents, each one of us would take a turn, grab a fistful of sleigh bells, and run off to our little corner. There wasn't any presents under the tree. Run off to our hiding spot and start shuttling packages back and forth from our hiding spot to under the tree. We put them under the tree. And as we were coming, like, downstairs from the second floor, we'd ring those sleigh bells. And that way you knew we were coming, and you were supposed to close your eyes and not peek. And then when we were all done, we would yell, "Open your eyes and be surprised." And voila, there'd be a new little clump of packages under the tree. So all the members of the family, it was just me, my sister, my dad, and my mom, would do this. And it was part of the tradition. And my wife and I still do it to this day. But the problem is, it's not the surprise anymore. Because if I've made a list, and there's one or two big ticket items on that list, like, let's say this year, a fish finder. That's what I'm getting for Christmas. I already know. Christmas ain't here yet. That's because it's on my list, and that's... And on her list, she's looking for a suitcase, a special kind of piece of luggage, for when she goes out to Vegas to shoot pool. So she kind of already knows what she's getting. So we do the sleigh bell thing, but then when you open your eyes and be surprised, you're not surprised. Because, oh, yeah, that's the right size box. Yep, that's what the fish locator comes in. Or, yeah, that's about the right size for a suitcase. There's no surprise. When I was a kid, we'd sit on the couch, and the person would yell, "Open your eyes and be surprised," and we'd be like, "Oh, look at the size of that one. Who's that for? I wonder if that's for me. I wonder if that's for my sister. Oh, man, what could be in there? That one's shaped like this." And your mind is just racing, and it's just, the excitement level just ramped up through the ceiling because you don't know. You didn't have any requests, and you fully didn't expect to have any of your requests fulfilled, so every single package was a surprise. Ah, Christmas was awesome. Granted, the stuff we got wasn't anything fabulous like it is today, you know, shirts and maybe Grandma knitted up a hat or something like that, but it was wrapped in a box, we had no idea what it was, and the surprise was there right up until the second we opened up and went, "Ah, socks." You know? So, that's what's missing. In my opinion, with this asking each other what you want for Christmas. In my opinion, you should be paying attention to the people in your life that you plan on getting Christmas gifts for. Paying attention to them every time you're with them. And noticing what they get excited about. You know, one friend of mine, you know, he's into fly fishing. And he saw these particular types of materials that he wanted for tying flies. And he got all excited. And I just lodged that up here in the mind bank. And now when I need a Christmas gift for him, pull that off the shelf, wrap it up. He won't know what he's getting. He's never told me what he wanted. He'll open it up. "Oh, dude, that's that fly stuff we saw." And he's all excited. That's what Christmas should be about. Not about, "Hon, what do you want for Christmas?" "Oh, I'd like a turquoise ring." "Oh, okay, I'll take a fish finder." And Christmas morning comes. We rip the paper off the packages. We already know what's inside. So, that's just my opinion. And talking too much here, I can't keep my pipe lit. So it's a cold night here in Wisconsin, and I'm sitting by the fire. Enjoying some big band Christmas music. Smoking some Star of the East, and a room temperature Lining Kugel's Fireside Nut Brown. Good deal. We'll catch you all on the flip side.